the brawling world champion Sheamus all over Del Rio.
Oh, no! What I like about Sheamus, he's about coming out.
Oh,
check this out. Ooh. Sheamus is all about business, man. Taking care of business. That's what he's doing right now with this kid, Del Rio. Ooh.
And look at Del Rio just being assaulted by Sheamus.
He just got bounced off that barrier right there.
Oh, and Sheamus continues the beating on Del Rio.
Yeah, the world champion with a purpose here tonight.
Oh, Rodriguez again. Rat.
And again, the numbers game.
Man.
The numbers game catching up to Sheamus. And now Del Rio continuing the message that he sent last night on Monday Night Raw. He's going to go a little too far here.
Come on, Sheamus.
He's going to go a little too far
here. You better fight back.
Ooh! He's assaulting Sheamus to the hood of the car. I'll tell you, this is a different Alberto Del Rio than we've seen in the past.
No, this is the guy right here trying to repeat.
You're right, Booker. It's all about his destiny, becoming the world champion. In Corpus Christi, and Sheamus will take control, but the numbers game would come into play here with Del Rio's his ring announcer, Rodriguez, would get involved.
Ricardo Rodriguez trying to get the best of Sheamus, but it provided the distraction for Alberto Del Rio. And then, as Booker pointed out, we saw a different side of Alberto Del Rio, a more vicious side of Del Rio.
It's something we haven't seen out of Del Rio as of late. But he is hell-bent on winning the World Heavyweight Championship in a couple of weeks at Money in the Bank. And you see Rodriguez directing traffic. And watch this. Alberto Del Rio with the hood of the car. Directly to the skull of Sheamus. And that will be it. One after another to the skull of Sheamus. An assault by Del Rio. Again. You talked about it, Booker. And we've talked about it in the past as well. Del Rio claims this is his destiny to become the world champion. As we take another look, medical personnel still trying to get Sheamus out of the arena. Obviously, we've been watching this during the commercial break. Sheamus extremely dazed, doesn't quite seem to know where he's at.
I'll tell you what, Sheamus right now is beat up because Del Rio is a rich kid who got a lot of street cred. This guy right here, it's all about his destiny. That's Del Rio, man.
But again, Booker, you might not like the way he did things, but what Del Rio's doing is he's sending a message. He wants to be world champion. He's doing everything he can to get to that point.
Let me tell you, Del Rio, since day one, it's always been about him. And today, going into this next big pay-per-view, it's all about Alberto Del Rio.
Well, the question will be asked, did Alberto Del Rio go too far? We'll have more on Sheamus as he's being evaluated as soon as we get an update, guys.
The following is a mixed tag team match scheduled for one fall. Introducing first the team of the Divas Champion, Layla, and the Great Khali.
And you guys saw the big barbecue going on, the 4th of July party out in the parking lot area, headed by our interim SmackDown General Manager, Theodore Long. Tonight, we understand that the superstars involved going to be tweeting their comments about that rocket party all night long. I wish you were out there, Book.
Actually, I actually made some of the barbecue ribs for that party, man. I'm telling you, it was old like a steaming pot of neck bones, you dog.
And Theodore Long put this mixed tag team match together. Look at the size difference between former world champion, the Great Khali, who goes over 7 feet tall, and the current Divas champion, Layla.
Don't tell me you used JR's barbecue sauce on your ribs.
Yes, I did.
Oh, please.
Big shout out to JR,
and your
baby.
Opponent, the team of Oksana and Antonio Sassano.
And Cole, you mentioned that Theodore Long is in control tonight. He's the interim general manager, much to the chagrin of Oksana and Antonio Cesaro.